Phil, what's your view on what's going on right now in the United States? I mean, it's very tragic what happened in Minnesota, what happened in Dallas, what happened in Tennessee. What do you think? Is there a solution to this? I mean, you never owned a gun, and you've lived most of your adult life in the United States. You played when you were very young. You were drafted into the NHL. You played for the Chicago Blackhawks. You played for the Boston Bruins for most of your career. And then you ended your career in New York, right? And then you started a hockey team in Tampa. And Florida's got, Florida's a big state for the guns. Is a big part of Florida's enforcement of the Second Amendment.
Yeah, well, that's right. There is. But gun control isn't going to do it. Remember when they tried prohibition? That didn't do it either. Look. For me, yeah, I don't know why they say Black Lives Matter. Why doesn't all lives matter?
Well, Rudy Giuliani tried to say that, and he was criticized and ostracized by the press, and ostracized by a lot of people in the movement, and in the press. But I really believe, I understand that in the United States, it's very tough if you're black. Especially if there's racial profiling. But lives matter, and I agree that lives in general of every human being matter. But I understand, I truly understand, and I'm not trying to be politically correct because I really don't give a fuck about being politically correct. I really understand the other side. I've always prided myself and tried to see both sides of the fence, right? Sometimes it doesn't necessarily mean that I'm going to make the right decision, but a police stops a guy in Minnesota, he panics, shoots the guy and kills him.
Yeah, well, I mean, the cop will be arrested and he'll be tried for murder. That's simple. I mean, unless there's something else, but I wonder if there are any white guys killed, white people getting killed by cops. Do we ever hear about that?
Yeah, but here's the argument, Phil. I'm glad you brought that up. That's very perceptive of you. Here's the argument. The argument is that it's a small percentage of what happens. The biggest problem in the United States right now, and I believe it probably happens in Canada, is racial profiling. So the police stop a black person versus a white person. Their adrenaline gets going. In Canada, it's guns are illegal, and nobody can have a concealed weapon. There's no Second Amendment, which gives you the right to bear arms. So I would say the police have less of even though their adrenaline is still going when they're stopping somebody, because it doesn't matter that guns are illegal in Canada. The United States is next door where guns are legal, right? And there's a lot that come over the border. Here's my problem. Here's my fucking problem. I understand everybody's argument. I do. I truly do. Here's my problem. How do you condone in Dallas? It's peaceful. A guy comes in, kills five police officers, wounds a ton of people. A mother jumps in front of her kid to save his life.
Yeah, and she gets shot in the leg.
How do you condone?
But
the police are putting their lives on the line for everybody's life. How do you condone that?
I don't condone it, but I can tell you this. I just did some research on very interesting facts about gun control, There are 30,000 gun-related deaths per year by firearms. That's not disputed by anybody. But here it is. 65% of those deaths are by suicide, which never would be prevented by gun laws. 15% are by law enforcement in the line of duty. 17% are through criminal activity, gang and drug-related or mentally ill persons. 3% are accidental discharge deaths. And where are the biggest homicides? 480 homicides in Chicago, 344 in Baltimore, 333 in Detroit, and 119 in Washington, D.C. Now, you think about that. In those towns, there's a big, huge black population. Where do they get their guns? That's the only thing. I think there should be a stricter, more comprehensive investigation when people try to buy guns. That I agree with, without a doubt. You have to. You just have to before you can let them buy it.
Well, yeah, but Phil, here's the problem, and I agree with you 1,000,000,000%. Here's the fucking problem. And what you said, a lot of experts have said exactly what you said, that they want to do a proper screening and that there's got to be a longer wait time. But the NRA says bullshit.
The NRA says bullshit. Well, it's negotiable, isn't it? It really is.
Apparently it's not, because everybody who's tried...
Well, I agree with you implicitly.
A lot of people have tried to have a longer screening time where they and I believe if you want to honor the Second Amendment, God bless you. That's fine. I'm not going to argue that, okay? It's the Second Amendment, even though that it was written a long time ago, right? If you want to honor that, I'm fine. I'm not going to argue it.
Wait. Let me say this. In all, you know those cities I just gave you, Chicago, Baltimore, Detroit, and Washington, those cities have the strictest gun laws in the country.
Well, right now in the United States of America, from what I'm reading, and you can correct me, Phil, because you're a voracious reader and you love understanding things, the most strictest gun law in the United States of America to own a handgun is in New York State.
No, it's not. It's in Chicago.
I thought it was New York State. So I'm glad. Thank you for correcting me. I read that it was New York State, but in Chicago. But there's a lot, like, it's almost like when you were a kid and you weren't old enough to buy cigarettes. You go get somebody to buy a gun for you. But here's the problem, Phil, that a lot of people who are trying to be experts or writing about this is that Chicago's got strict gun laws, but then you go to the next state, right? And they have these big, huge gun conventions or selling of guns, like exposés, and there's no waiting time. You can buy whatever you want.
Well, let me ask you this, and all of you. Do you think if they took the Second Amendment out, it would stop anything? Did it stop in prohibition of getting booze?
I think prohibition was the biggest mistake in the world. I believe if you want to buy a gun, you buy a gun. In Canada,
if bad guys want to get guns, they're going to get them. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, but you need to listen to me, Phil. I don't want to argue with you today, and I agree with what most of the stuff.
No, yes, you do. Yes, you do.
No, I'm saying that if you want to sell a gun in the United States, you need to have very strict laws on how to buy a gun.
I'm not going to disagree with you there. I agree with you. But they have the strictest laws in Chicago, the city of Chicago, and they have the most homicides. And it's all by guns, basically.
Here's my rebuttal to that, Phil. You can buy a gun in the next state and bring it over.
Yeah.
So you can't buy, like what I'm saying is when I was a kid and you wanted to smoke a pack of cigarettes, and they put the age lie in, you would wait for somebody who was older than you, you give them an extra $2, and you'd go buy a pack of cigarettes.